Hello, dear friends and subscribers. Welcome to Cricket Happenings. On this part of the Cricket Happenings show, what I have for you today is a brief preview of the second One Day International, which is coming up between Bangladesh and the West Indies. And as you know, this is a three match ODI series. And tomorrow is going to be a day-night game compared to the day game that was played at the Providence Stadium in Guyana. And one can say that Bangladesh are the ones who are really at an advantage, because if they win this particular match, they are the ones who would be winning the series. So, and West Indies would definitely for West Indies, it's definitely a must-win match. So I'll be doing a brief preview of that match, and then the much-awaited clash, which has been a sort of a rarity nowadays because of no exchanges between two Asian countries, India and Pakistan. As you know, they clashed in the Champions Trophy, where Pakistan had the better of India. But I can tell you one thing, that definitely one is going to see some cricket long last, and you can mark that date on your calendars, dear friends and subscribers. I'm talking about the Asia Cup, which is coming up in the month of September. September 19 is the date you should mark it down on your calendar, because as I have said, India and Pakistan have had rarest of exchanges. Nowadays, there is no cricket being played between India and Pakistan, but it is coming, dear fans and subscribers, in the Asia Cup. The arch rivals will be battling it out in Dubai on 19th of September. And as I once again say, mark it down in your calendars. And this is the match of the Asia Cup. This is Asia Cup, which is being played in the United Arab Emirates. And September 19 is the clash between India and Pakistan in Dubai. The six teams will take part in the Asia Cup. They would be divided into two groups. For the first time, an Asia Cup is going to be divided. Previously, all the Asia Cups has been a sort of clashes where each team has to play the other at least once, but now things have changed. In fact, they have been divided into two groups, and India and Pakistan are drawn in the same group, and they have featured six teams. So there's a qualifying tournament. So basically, six teams will take part in the Asia Cup along with Sri Lanka, Afghanistan, and Bangladesh. And then the sixth team will be determined with a qualifying tournament that will take place from 29th of August to September 6th. And the teams that would be playing in the qualifying tournament are Singapore, Hong Kong, Malaysia, Nepal, Oman, and the home team itself, United Arab Emirates. And they would definitely love to qualify, but they definitely are going to face a lot of challenges with the other teams as well, especially with Oman, who is an upcoming team, as we all know, and also Nepal and Hong Kong. Well, only Singapore and Malaysia could be probably dismissed, but other than that, it is going to be a sort of a three-way race, according to me, in the qualifying tournament. And so that is the Asia Cup, which is coming up, and as I said, everything will point out towards the India-Pakistan clash on September 19. So, and the other than that, one more news that I could share before I go into the brief preview of the second ODI, which is coming up tomorrow between Bangladesh and West Indies. The Sri Lankan squad was named. As you know, the Sri Lankans have crushed the South Africans with their spinners. And now one is going to get into some sort of a different territory altogether. And this is One Day International series, which is coming up. It's a five-match ODI series, which is coming up between Sri Lanka and South Africa. And Sri Lanka would definitely like to make the most of it. And also have a look at the team. Angelo Matthews has been named the captain of this five-match ODI series against South Africa. And Dinesh Chandimal has not been included in the squad. So Dinesh Chandimal, after the episode that happened, he has not even been included in the squad. And there are a few new names coming up. There's a left-arm spinner by the name Prabhat Jayasurya, who has been doing well in domestic cricket, and also they have the other spinners as well, Akhila Dhananjaya and Lakshman Sandarkan. And if you look at the team there, the team has Kasun Rajita, who has definitely made his debut. Prabhat Jayasuriya is the left-arm spinner. Shehan Jayasuriya has played a few matches as well. He's a sort of a one-day specialist. Angelo Matthews himself. And Dustin Shanaka, who's a very, very hard-hitting all-rounder as well. And the persons who have lost their places, Dushmanta Chamira. I was really surprised that Asela Gunaratne, who was one of the key figures when they went to Australia, unfortunately has been overlooked, and one does not know what is the reason, because Asela Gunaratne one thought was sort of a very good upcoming talent. So one is I'm a bit surprised that Asela Gunaratne has not made the cut. Nuwan Pradeep does not find a place. Dhanushka Gunatilaka is in some trouble after being banned from all formats. Shane Madushanka is one who is a good bowler when I've seen him, but he has no chance. Vanindu Hasranga has also been knocked out. So they've gone for some all-rounders like Shehan Jayasuriya and Dashun Shanaka. And Angelo Matthews will be the one who will be leading the side against South Africa. And definitely for South Africa, it will be a sort of a real test because at least they know for a fact that ODIs would be something where South Africa could come into their own. So now, the last thing that I'm going to do on this cricket show is going to be a brief preview, as I promised, the second ODI. The first ODI was won by Bangladesh. Now, what West Indies need to do? Let's have a look at that. As I said, it's a must-win match for the West Indies. And what can West Indies do? West Indies probably have to get their fielding right. They dropped a lot of catches in the previous match, and I'm sure their coach would have worked that out with them. And so that is something that the fielding is the one which has to really, really sharpen up for West Indies, according to me. That's the first thing. Other than that, their batting, they have some very good players in the mix. Chris Gayle, Evan Lewis, Shai Hope, Jason Mohammed, Shimron Hetmyr. He's already showing that what a budding talent he's becoming. Jason Holder, the captain of the side. Roman Powell, the all-rounder. Andre Russell, always a dangerous player to any opposition in the world. Devendra Bishu, the spin would be in the hands of Bishu and Nurse. And Alzari Joseph. There's only one genuine pace bowler in the team, and there is Alzari Joseph. One does not know whether that is the right way to go, because Jason Holder has been having a good time against Bangladesh. So probably that's a precise reason they have decided to go with two spinners in the mix. But definitely West Indies, for them, it's a must-win match. If at all they lose the match tomorrow, it's all over for the West Indies. So I'm sure they're pretty much aware about that, and one would probably see West Indies really getting into their groove tomorrow. Bangladesh, well, they would be very happy with the win that they got in the first ODI, and I don't foresee any changes coming up. They probably would retain the same team, and definitely it's a confident Tamim Iqbal. But what Bangladesh should be hoping tomorrow, even though they have won, they know that if they win it tomorrow, they can relax in the final ODI, three-match ODI series. And Tamim Iqbal and Shakib Al Hasan have already done very well in the first ODI. They have nothing to worry. Mushfiqur Rahim, Mahmudullah, Sabir Rahman. There's a very good bunch of Mashraf Muttaz has come up with some good bowling as well. I don't think Bangladesh would like to leave it to the final ODI. They would like to go a full pelt at the West Indies tomorrow. And the main thing that Bangladesh would be needing tomorrow is for forging a very good opening partnership to set up a platform. Tamim Iqbal. And also, let us say that, again, this is going to be played on the same pitch. And it would be interesting to see how it goes. There's also some lot of rain also in the forecast. And Shakib Al Hasan has, Shakib Al Hasan already said, the Guyana climate is probably much like Bangladesh. So he says that that is not going to surprise them. So they would feel at home playing at the Providence Stadium in Guyana. But the only difference being, It's a day-night test match which is coming up with a white ball. Well, dear fans, subscribers, nothing else to add. England, India definitely getting ready. They were going to play their first match against Essex, and due to really this year, we have been seeing some very, very hot conditions in England, which is necessarily not. And also, the reason I am actually raising that point is that if the sun is going to shine brightly like what it was, I'm sure the Indians will have a field day against England in the Test series. But one thing that I can say that last year, when India toured England, it was very, very swinging and seeming conditions. It was perfectly ideal for the English bowlers. So England would be hoping that it turns around. But India would be hoping that the sun stays, and that is one chance where India can dominate, as we all know. Well, dear fans, subscribers, nothing else to really add. It was a pleasure bringing you this daily cricket show. I hope you all liked it. With my next cricket show slated tomorrow, that's on the Wednesday. It's time for me to bid you all a very good night.